This tutorial will show you how to create a backup plan which will copy your data from one Seagate Business Storage NAS to another. To get started creating your backup plan, launch the NAS manager for the destination NAS and log in as an administrator. Once the dashboard displays, click on the Protect menu item. After the Protect menu section expands, click on Protect Server Settings. The first step is to set up an alias on the destination NAS. An alias is a hidden folder on the destination drive which will store the backed up data. First, remove the default names and enter an authentication name and password for the alias. Next, enter a name for the alias folder. Then, use the drop-down menu to select the volume on the destination drive to which you will save your alias. To continue, put a check in the Enable Backup Service radio button. After you have supplied all the required information, click on the Save button. Next, launch the NAS manager for the source NAS and log in as an administrator. Once the dashboard displays, click on the Protect menu item. When the Protect menu section expands, click on Protect Job Manager. Once the Protect Job Manager page displays, click on the NAS to NAS Backup tab. Then click on the New Protect Job button. The next step is to provide the IP address, the alias name, and the authentication name and password for the destination NAS. To continue, click on the Detect IP Address button. The Backup Server drop-down menu will populate with a list of the NAS devices you have on your network. Open the drop-down menu and click on the name of the NAS device that you want to use as the destination drive. The IP address fields will automatically populate with the IP address of the NAS device you selected. Next, use the alias name drop-down menu to select the alias or enter the name manually. Then, enter the authentication name and password in the fields provided. After you have supplied the required information, you can check the connection to the destination NAS by clicking on the Test Connection button. A pop-up window will display advising you of the connection status. To continue, enter a name for the new backup job. Next, select the data that you want to add to your backup plan. Click on the plus sign to expand the tree structure and navigate to the data you want to back up. Then, click on and highlight the files or folders that contain the data you want included in the plan. The data that has been added to the plan will be listed under the source directory window and will be copied to the destination folder. This is all the information necessary to set up a one-time backup job. Optionally, you may schedule your backup plan to run at a time and frequency of your choice. To schedule the frequency of your plan, first select the days you want the backups to occur. You may backup your data daily or select one or more days of the week to have your plan run. To make a selection, put a check in the appropriate checkboxes. Then use the Backup Time drop-down list to select the time of day you want the backup to begin. You may also use the Backup Time drop-down to schedule a one-time job to run later the same day. After you have provided all the required information, click on the Add Job button to add your backup job and have it run at the time you have scheduled, or click on the Add and Start Now button to add your backup job and have it begin running immediately. You will be notified of the status once the backup begins running. Clicking on the Edit icon will launch the Edit page where you may change any of the settings for your backup plan. Clicking the Delete button will delete the backup plan. However, all of the previously backed up data will remain on the destination drive. These are all the steps required to set up a backup plan using two Seagate Business Storage NAS devices. For more information on the product and its features, please view the rest of the Seagate Business Storage NAS tutorials.